Hello explorers, welcome to our channel Explorers Basic Hunt. In today's video we'll be talking about the places to visit in Mahabalipuram. We will also be sharing with you the short info about these places. Krishna Mandapam. This is an amazing piece of architecture where a cave has been cut out of a single piece of rock with the story of Krishna. Well worth a look in this area of interesting rock sculptures. It's over a 1000 years old piece of art. The carving inside are sculpted panels that depict the might of Krishna lifting the Govardhan hill to protect the cowherds and the gopis or the milkmaids from heavy rains and floods. The might related to the depiction is linked to Indra. Lord Indra was annoyed with the people of the village known as Mathura as they discontinued celebration of a festival in his honor. He created a huge storm with heavy rain showers threatening the life of the villagers. Lord Krishna lifted the Govardhan hill creating an umbrella of protection and saving the village and its people. Another relief, Krishna is shown in a joyous mood with its gopis and a reflection which shows his double role as a divine being. Other reliefs carved on the walls of the cave depict an elderly person carrying a child on his shoulders, a village scene of cowherds milking a cow, the cow licking the calf. There are gopis with the water pots on their heads, flute, woodcutter walking with an axe, and a lady carrying a milk pot and a rolled mat, a bundle of grass, a child hugging her mother. The carvings in the Krishna cave are reported to be very realistic. Shiva Temple or Shiv Temple. The rich architecture of Palvas is adorable and every piece of stone here stands as a testimony to the Palwa architecture. The Shiva Temple, a World Heritage Site, was built by the Palwa king Raja Simha in the 7th century, made from the sandstone with a granite base. It is the earliest important structural temple in southern India. It is a good example of temples constructed in the Dravidian style. Travel to the history with the astonishing view in and out of the Shiva Temple and its surrounding, maintained by the Archaeological Department of India. This place is right next to the shore. Among the 7 temples, 6 of them were submerged and this is one left out. Beautifully built and lot of sculptures. There is a big Shiva Linga and said to be built with granite. The temple's 3 sanctuaries are dedicated to Shiva and Vishnu. The temple has 2 tall pyramid-shaped towers topped by octagonal domes. The temple walls are topped by large sculptures of Nandi. The best place to have great photography, street food and shopping is an add-on at these temples. Back of the temple is blue pristine great waters of the Bay of Bengal. One cannot forget the lifetime experience that this place can offer. Vishnu Temple. This temple is among the 108 Divya Disham or must visit holy temples and it lies in the 61st place on the list. Lord Vishnu appears in the teaching posture, having his hands on the chest. It is said that Mahabali Chakravarti ruled this tala and as per the boon that he got from the Vamana, one of the incarnations of the Lord Vishnu, this tala is named as Mahabalipuram. Once Mamallapuram or Mahabalipuram sea region was a dense forest. Since Pundarika was performing penance here, he saw a lotus flower in nearby tank and liked to place this flower at the feet of the Lord Narayana in the milk ocean. After picking up these flowers, he went towards the Lord's feet, but the sea obstructed his march. To make the way, he began to dry the sea by removing this water day and night. This went for years. He got too tired and he cried, "O Lord, if I am your true devotee, let the sea dry and make way for me. Till such time I reach you with this flower should not fade off." He was fully concentrating on the Lord. Lord appeared before him as an aged man. That old man asked the sage to get him some food as he was hungry and also advised him to stop this impossible task. The sage asked the old man to hold this flower basket, wait till he brought food for him, saying that he was determined to see Perumal. He placed the flowers at his feet and would not rest till then. The sage then went to bring food for the old man. Before he returned, Perumal wore all the flowers on his Tirumani. It was shock for the sage to see his lord. As Lord appears in his reclining position, he is praised or reclining Perumal. The beauty of this temple is Lord Shiva in sleeping pose but not normal on the usual snake. Fairathas. Pancharathas, also known as Fairathas, is a complex of monolithic rock-cut temples dating back to the mid-7th century. The Pancharathas are named after the five Pandava brothers, heroes of the Indian epic Mahabharata. They are Draupadi Ratha, Nakula Sahadeva Ratha, Bhima Ratha, Dharmaraja Ratha. The shrine panels are richly carved with Hindu deities. It is an awesome place. The area is small, but the history and the sculpture carving are mesmerizing. All the five temples were carved out of a single stone. Two things which make the Rathas unique. The first is the stones were cut in situ. The second is that the styles and the techniques of wooden architecture were imitated in stone, creating a variety of form. This would later influence very distinct South Indian temple design. The temples were never finished, so none of them were used for worship. Another important places to visit in this region is the Maritime Museum and the Heritage Museum, where you can connect with the history of this place. Mahabalipuram Lighthouse. This 14,000 years old lighthouse stands proud on the shore of the Bay of Bengal. This tower was built using natural stone with perfect balancing structure. The Mahabalipuram Lighthouse is built on a rock. The Mahabalipuram Lighthouse is located 55 km south of Chennai, and although just a century old compared to more Asian sites in town, the lighthouse offers a unique charm. The steep steps inside and the view of the top is really mesmerizing. You find a circular step to reach onto the top. There is a small charge for the tourist to go up, but it's well worth it. There are some decent views from the top and the surrounding area is really nice. One of the most important place to visit in this area is the India Seashell Museum. Started by Mr. Raja Mohammed a few years back, this museum has a massive collection of seashells. It has been collected over 33 years. The Seashell Museum is one of the most unique thing one can see in his lifetime. There are approximately 40,000 seashells carefully arranged to explain what a man is capable of when he pursues his passion. From shells ranging in colors and size, everything regarding seashells can be seen here. The place is fully air-conditioned. You will also find a pearl museum just next to it, which consists of various displays of natural and cultured pearls with an aquarium, which is small but has some unique kind of fishes. You can also hold a live starfish on your palms, as it is the first interactive aquarium of its kind. The attached is the store named Maya Bazaar, where you can find seashells and other shell products.
एक्सप्लोर हो रहा है।